1931 saw the inception of the annual series between the Penang Sports Club and the Royal Bangkok Sports Club. Two trophies being contested, the Tiger Trophy for hockey held in 1965 by Bangkok and the Elephant Trophy, retained by the PSC by virtue of a drawn cricket match held at Penang in 1965. The PSC members had been looking forward to the trip, and competition for places in the team had been keen. The weather was glorious and the journey by Comet 4 passed pleasantly and quickly. The only jarring note was the sight of the waiting USAF military aircraft at Bangkok Airport, grim reminders of the uneasy peace which sits over Southeast Asia today. Passing from the shade of the comet into the brilliant Bangkok sunshine, such grim portents were quickly forgotten, and the PSC members were in high spirits. The journey from the airport to the Royal Bangkok Sports Club proved fascinating, especially for those visiting Bangkok for the first time. Old friendships were renewed and new ones made before it was time for the bully off for the Tiger Trophy. The game was clean and well contested. Fortune swayed each way. Both sides made some excellent openings and there were some tense times for both teams' supporters. Then Bangkok began to get the edge. They went into the lead and skillfully kept it to win by 2-1. Thus retaining the Tiger Trophy for yet another year. At the inevitable after-match inquest, it was generally agreed that the better team had won. So the honour of Penang rested with the cricket 11. There was no doubt in skipper Chris Allen's mind that only an all-out effort by everyone could pull it off. Bangkok won the toss and elected to bat first. Fielding was good, bowling aggressive, and the Bangkok openers were soon in difficulties, both being dismissed for a total of only 5 runs. But Cobb and Pereira, numbers 3 and 4, stopped the rot and laid the foundation for a good innings. The interruption of play for the half-hourly horse race proved a welcome respite to both sides. The sun blazed down and steadily the score mounted. There was no doubt the Penang fielders were tired when the last Bangkok wicket fell for 162, a quite formidable score. Van Kylenberg and Halls, both with some good knocks behind them, looked quietly determined as they walked out to open the Penang innings. They settled down well, but things didn't look too good when Zainuddin Muir went in with the score 18 for 2. Zainuddin was joined by his father Hayati at 25 for 3, and this brilliant father-son partnership produced some glorious cricket before Hayati was out. The Penang score, then 82 for 4, looked good, but Zainuddin was out 7 runs later, and only an unbeaten 38 by Alcock saved the day for Penang. Their first innings score of 147 left them 15 runs behind. At this stage, some astonishing mistakes by the Bangkok skipper resulted in a drastic change of fortune. Aggressive batting took them to 70 for 4, before a sudden collapse saw them lose their grip on the game. A change of tactics might have prevented disaster, but it was not to be, and they were all out for 89. So Penang went in for their second innings, needing 105 to win. Some first-class batting by Hawes and Hayati Mir built a solid foundation of 78 for 3. The middle batsman failed to take advantage of this position and tension in the pavilion mounted as the score went to 92 for 8. But the tail-enders hung on, and finally, still with 2 wickets in hand, Penang passed the Bangkok total. Hard cricket and hot sun had exhausted them, but Penang were delighted to have retained the elephant trophy. We discreetly draw a veil over the evening's festivities. Suffice it to say, the several pairs of bloodshot eyes took refuge behind dark glasses the following morning as the Penang contingent prepared to board the aircraft home. When he saw the Thai aircraft waiting to take them back to Penang, one member was heard to say, "I hope they keep those flaming propellers quiet on the way home." The local Bangkok papers were full of praise for the Penang cricketers and rather critical of the tactics of the unfortunate Bangkok team. Whilst some read, some slept, and others just sat and thought. Smooth landing at Bayan La Pass marked the end of the return flight. First off the aircraft was the elephant. Skipper Allen claimed the right to carry him home. The remainder of the team disembarked, clutching their gifts and equipment. Some obviously had done this sort of thing many times before and had their cellophane wrapped peace offerings handy. So the elephant arrived back at the Penang Sports Club, back for the third year running to its place behind the bar, where it is a symbol not just of a victory at a cricket match, but of an enduring friendship between two rival clubs from neighbouring countries. A symbol of sportsmanship and respect of the highest order.